3 and we awoke to a fresh southwesterly wind. Initially we'd planned to go further up Loch Fyne, but we knew if we did it would be a fight heading south again if the waves got much bigger. So we decided to head for Inchmarnock instead and then take it from there. We enjoyed the hearty breakfast of bacon and sausage rolls before packing up camp, and at least the wind was keeping the midges away. We assembled in the relative shelter of a bay. Then once everybody was ready, we headed for open sea. Fresh wind soon blew away any cobwebs of the previous night's campfire festivities, and the bobbing of the boat soon settled the sausages in my stomach, so it didn't take too long to get to Inchmarnock, where we landed for a confab on our plans for the day and also another breakfast. I decided to have another swim to clear the last of the gravy from my system, and to make sure my dry suit hadn't sprung any leaks during the night. To save Sea Pup Fang's soul getting bounced out the boat, Gordon and Malcolm decided to head for Tighnabruaich and set up camp again, while the rest of us decided to go round the southern tip of Bute and have a play in the Garrick Head tide rip. Jake Figurvin clearly loved the boat bounce run, and when we turned north with wind blowing behind us, he had just as much fun. in amusement as the others crowded in and soaked him with their wake. Not that it bothered Big Jake, as he was drier than them in his new dry suit. Yep, he found out that dry suits certainly keep you dry in small wet boats, as well as when you go swimming. If he had been wearing desk trousers, he would have been soaked to the skin. Especially if he fell in. Alas, all too soon the fun run ended as we crossed Rossy Bay heading for the calm waters of the Kyles. Landed in a little bay in Bute, just across from Tighnabruaich. We set up camp, then set up a water taxi service to the Tighnabruaich Hotel, where we enjoyed our favourite evening tipples and some homemade lasagna. The following morning was not so windy as we headed back to Largs to recover the boats. We split into two groups and left at different times so as to avoid everyone arriving in a slipway at the same time. Another great multi-day adventure over, and my sincere thanks to everyone present. I look forward to next time. Thanks for watching.